It's an item. Come on, you.
This is Bruce Dauthi Taylor, and welcome back to another episode of Dauthi Plays Silence of the Sleep. Let's jump in here. I think it's a little bit funny considering that we have to start this episode by going and playing a song. Since I had to actually familiarize myself recently with Dot Wave production, and just like to say that while parts of that process are actually quite easy, especially with a good editor, that process as a whole is just not fun sometimes. It's hard to get things to sound just right, just the way you want them to. Now, got the code here still, or well, the tune we need. My essence tune, if you will. I'm just kind of hoping I have them in the right order. I don't want to have to go back and read that letter. I should have just continued recording as soon as possible, but I wanted to try to get some stuff done for the intro and the outro so that I didn't have to worry about that and I could just, you know, sit down and play the game. These hash marks are still disturbing, by the way. I wonder if we turn this way if you'll say anything about them. That's alright. Alright. Let's see here. Oh, okay. Nice. This way? Ah, there we go. Oh, good. I would not have been able to remember where E was and how the scale goes. I did remember the flats, though. Let's see here. One D flat. Two E, three F. There was no four. Five F, six E flat. No seven and eight is D. No, it's not gonna work. Can't press two. Oh, I'm going to have to go back to that note. Oops. Wrong button. Oh, good. Nice. E, F. Oh. No, okay. Yeah, E, 5. No, okay, I did. Alright, seems like I messed up one of my marks here. So glad it let me keep that. That's super useful and completely unexpected. Numbers and holes. E, F, E flat. See, there's no 4. There's no 7. E, F, E. I'm just gonna put them in that order. Wow, so that was pretty ridiculous. I actually had that the whole time sitting right in front of me, this code that we got off the mirror in the bathroom that tells you which order you have to do these numbers in, or these keys in. So that was all on me right there. All right, so 2 E, 6 E flat, 5 E, 3 F, 5 E, 8 D, and 1 D flat. Ta dance! I can't believe I needed a walkthrough for that. I feel ashamed. I'm sorry, guys. I haven't played video games in something like a week. So, this has been an experience for me. Oh, look, he got drunk playing the piano. Fantastic. It's a liquor-filled piano. No wonder Beethoven was always so angry. Rambunctious. He's always hammered. Oh, never mind. It's all House of Ashes, right? Ludwig. That's a manly name right there. Dun, dun, dun. Can I move and whatnot? No, eh? They're like, no, you sit and deal with what you've done. So yeah, I had to start working on making my own songs and stuff, and I found it difficult to kind of line it up properly where it doesn't sound like there's gaps in the middle of things. It's been working all right. I seem to be doing better with my bass lines than my rhythms. So, hopefully with a little bit more experience and practice, it won't be such a problem. Oop, starting to get smoky in here. Been practicing using vape to blow smoke rings. Getting pretty good at it now. I just need to get them to come out a little thicker so they're easy to see. Game over, Chief. We're going down. There seems to be a lot of hell theming going on here. I know I harp on this in pretty much every video, but Satan Daddy, fire, demons, ghosty demons. Your never-ending clock. Well, I guess no clock ever ends, but sure, time's not going by that quick. One year later. Satan Daddy gonna pop up and be like, this is your next trial. Welcome to the third circle of hell. Remember, I'm your friend. I just want to cut off your hands and feet. Oh, that's nice. I was so happy to see that he gave a copy of the soundtrack with the game, too. It's fantastic. There's actually quite a few of these songs I really like. Bloody bathtub. That's not a bad sign. Oh, the portrait. My girlfriend said she really liked that picture, actually. Oh. Wash closet, Satan statue. hey, there's that clock I was talking about. And, you know, my unfortunate slip and fall accident. Gotta remind me to sue that tree. Oh, good. New monster. Fantastic. The teleporting multi-headed one wasn't bad enough. Prepare to die, Brucey. Prepare to die. What can you see, Jacob? Words? Text? Blackness? I see my journey. The flashbacks. Pain. Indescribable pain. And a woman. Several, really. We totally cheated one out of a love life. She probably didn't want that guy anyways. Probably, you know what, I probably did that red-haired lady a favor. Chapter 3, The Treatment. Oh, this is like stages of grief, maybe, too? So many theories on this game I've had so far. Gives you a little bit of a loop, but not too much information. Oh. Hello, shiny coat. Coat's not so shiny now. Is it, Mr. Shiny Coat? Got some fancy degrees up on the wall there, I see. You an edumacated man? Thank you, Jacob. We should call it a day. Oh, I don't even get to talk to Mr. Not Shiny Coat? You arrived with such a short notice. It's getting late. You should head to bed. I'll show you around first thing tomorrow morning. Oh, I'm being admitted. Being admitted. There's Mr. Shiny Coat's guitar. Thought you just flashed me in for that. Alright, cool. I'm not even gonna go to bed, I'm just gonna chill in the chair. This guy took a nap in a hall while Blondie took off, though, so I wouldn't put much past him. That guy sleeps anywhere. Hey, I remember you. You cut my head off. Oh, you gonna do it again? You gonna show everybody my nasty death? They missed too many of them already. Mr. Shiny Coat, there's an intruder. Screen's picking up so much dust lately, it's ridiculous. It's nice to get some sunshine, though. Jacob? Time to wake up. But I don't wanna. I was having such sweet dreams. Hey, Mr. Shiny Coat, where'd you go? You outside? Where the hell am I now? Huh. My flashlight is gone.
Day one. The place in the mist. Chill.
So now there's going to be several parts to the chapters. This game is so much longer than I expected it to be, but I love it. I'm completely okay with it. You see that little, like, twitch out flash he did right there?
You don't understand the depth of this painting. It's white on white on white representing the snowbird. God. Plebeians.
Junk. I don't need it.
Neanderthals.
Hey, Mr. Not Shiny Coat. Good morning, Jacob. How did... Patient rooms? There was one room. Oh, patient room 6. Okay. Didn't see that. My bad. How did you sleep? Morning. Hey, I know you from the motel. Let's talk these things through later, Jacob. Okay, so is this gonna pull some, like, Darkness 2 bullshit where, like, the evilness is trying to trick you into thinking you're insane so it can take you over? Fucking darkness. But now, follow closely and I'll show you around. I don't know anybody who chose to stay in the insanity, but apparently it did happen. Come on, Jacob, don't go wandering around. Oh, he won't even let me. All right. I get it. I'm a patient. I'm not allowed to do stuff. So, Shiny Coat, what's up? What's for breakfast? I'd like some eggs, pancakes, sausage, coffee? Definitely coffee. Oh, yes. Your room is number 6. Yeah. I thought it was an S, bro. We have 9 patient rooms here in Moon Peaks Care. I almost said Crescent. You can find most of these rooms in this hallway. So tell me where other people are. Well, that's not good, right? Shouldn't be going directly to their rooms and stuff. Patients, mental patients and stuff. Especially me. If I'm crazy, I'm really, really crazy. You can move freely about, but remember the good manners, Jacob. So it's like real, like min security. Okay, let us continue. Okay. Oh, so you're just going to be a tour of this, and then it's going to go all Silent Hilly on me, and then I got to go back through it. You just don't want to give me a map. You got to make me remember it. All right. That's cool. Patient rooms, cool. Nine patient rooms. I'm 6. Did I miss something? It sounds like my steps, yeah, sounded like my steps were getting farther away, but you can't really see them. Here we have one of the main wards of our care. Most of the second floor is a simple square, so getting around is pretty easy. Alright. Make that. Hey, look at the clock! But I'll show you. Come on, Jacob. Okay. This is all normal time now, so. Just on my flashlight? Nope. No flashlight. From here, you can go to our little entertainment room. So, entertainment room, my room. This is where the people usually gather together for recreation. Once we are finished with our tour, be sure to check it out. Cool. Works for me. Yeah, TV, cable, and satellite in this joint. Swear to God, if there isn't a TiVo, I will straight up murder somebody. People still use TiVo, by the way? Like, digital recorders, yes, but the actual TiVo brand. The last I heard about TiVo, Family Guy was ripping the shit out of them. Here we have our fireplace. That's definitely safe around a bunch of mental patients. Giant flaming fire and a moose head. Nothing quite as relaxing as the sound of fire and the flickering of the flames. That's gotta be a fire hazard. Look how close all that crap is to that fire. And that thing is going, like, through the bars. That's redonkulous. Hey, Doc. Morning, Mark. How are you today? Pretty good, thank you, Doc. But who is this? Do we have a new patient? Yes, Mark. This is Jacob. Welcome to the loony bin, Jacob. Oh, that's... Boom. Promo! Jacob arrived here late yesterday evening. Would you give him a little breathing room, Mark? Ah, of course. Sorry, Doc. That's fine, Mark. I'm sure you two will get along well. But now, where were we? Talking about the fire hazard. The obvious fire hazard that's going on in this setup here. Look at this. Look at that. No wonder the one place burned down. People are just like, bah, fire. Can't hurt anybody. Now from here, you can get to both our entertainment and art therapy rooms. Okay. Art therapy. That's some pretty high-class stuff here. The bathroom, it just has a curtain over it. Oh, okay. It just leads to the bathrooms. We keep the art therapy room locked when we don't use it. You'll get to see it at some point. It's a really breathtaking place. Yeah. I believe that. Alright, let's just give this a little savey wave ski here. Oh, I can't even. Can't even. This episode is just blowing my mind right now. At the far end, you can find the elevator that will take you to the first floor. It's smaller than the living quarters up here, but we go there every now and then to eat, for example. Oh, excuse me. Well, let's not go there now, but up here. Come, Jacob. I need an adult. I need an adult. He is leading me to the bathroom. I need an adult. Stranger danger. Stranger danger. Listen, Doc. I'm crazy, alright? I'm in a psych ward. Alright? And not a good one, either. Look how moldy and fucking just messed up this place is. So I'm nuts. So you try any shit with me, I'll bite your dick off. Here you can find bathrooms. We also have two bathrooms downstairs. Not much else to see here. Let's continue. That's right, I said it. Yeah. That scared you off, didn't it? Oh, it's another one of these things. All right. I wonder if maybe I have to wait for the doctor to get over there. Well, I was sprinting this time, so yeah, maybe it's just that long drag out. Holy. Yeah, this might get a little confusing at some point. Here we have the rest of the patient rooms. I wonder if you can just run. You know what I mean? In one direction. It'll just, like, circle you around in this big square. Yeah, you have nowhere to hide. You just have to continue running and hope it doesn't trap you in a room somewhere. Hey, look, outside. Are we allowed outside, or what's the deal with that, Doc? And here's my office. I will always keep my door locked when I'm not present. But if you see me through the window... Ah, okay, it's his office, not outside. My bad. Chair. Obvious now. But if you see me through the window and I don't look too busy, you're welcome to talk to me. Alright, let's get back to your room. This way, Jacob. Hey, man. If this is men's security, then why do you gotta walk me back to my room? I'm a grown boy. Look at me. If I'd done half the shit I suspected I'd done, I'm sure I'm just fine. Oh! No, no. Okay, so you'd have to... Alright. Sorry, Jacob. I'm awfully busy now, so it was a pretty short tour. There's not really much here, man. Unless you start taking me through people's rooms. But feel free to look around and be sure to talk to all the people. It is breakfast time. You should head downstairs. Once you're familiar with the places and people, come and talk to me, and we can begin your very first hypnotherapy. Oh, good. Okay, thank you, Jacob. See you later. Thanks, Mr. Ah, pardon me. Clifford Russell, at your service. Okay, thanks, Clifford. Ah. Yeah, all right. This guy's mind is in somewhere you don't want to be, apparently. I kind of want to end the video here to keep it from getting too long, but I don't want the video to be just my talking. We had a little bit of stuff happen here, but it's not really too exciting yet. I kind of want to have a little something happen. So we're going to go check out the entertainment and the art therapy rooms at least. Maybe head down for some breakfast. See how that goes. This guy seems pretty frank with me too. I might have a little chat ski with him. Yeah, I'll talk to you first. Hey, buddy. What's going on? Hey, Mark, was it? Hello, Jacob. Yeah, they call me Mark. Huh? It's pretty quiet here. Yeah, I think people are having breakfast downstairs. It gets more lively once they are back up. I see. Sorry to ask, Jacob, but are you okay? You look a bit distracted. I'm fine, thanks. Just a bit tired. Yeah, that's why we are here. Hope that helps. I'm off to have a look around. Bye, Mark. Talk to you later, Jacob. That was a productive conversation. I feel like we got a lot done, so video over. I'll probably, you know, cut that last bit out, because that was quite a bit.
Useless! Fucking useless!
Alright, moving on.
Useless! Let's go dumpster diving.
It's empty, and since when did I start searching trash cans? Yeah, you're right to chastise me, man. You're totally within your right there. What the fuck are you doing? Alright, ooh. Cool. Music is an art. Music is an art. What do we got here? Technical manuals. How to escape a mental asylum. Do you want to read it? This is a published novel. That's it, eh? Well, apparently the traditional art, as in painting and crafting, it's no. There'll be none of that. You read or you play music. Oh wait, no, this is entertainment. This isn't art. Never mind. Duh. Painting therapy. Cool. Well then, good for them for not having a TV. Locked.
I have a master key! No.
That's unfortunate. Why do they lock? Oh. Yeah, well, okay. A paintbrush. You probably stab somebody with that. Counterproductive. Yeah, so sure. Sitting there calling it the art room the whole time. It's the entertainment room. Alright, let's go get some brekkie. See, they got some coffee and bacon in this beach. What are those doors? What do you do? Locked. Of course it is. Let me guess. Psychic powers tell me locked. Oh. More bathrooms down here. It's probably a good idea. It's actually probably, well, yeah, probably a good idea. What's this? We got a menu? Got filet mignon. Duck à l'orange. Shit on a shingle. Oh, okay. Mr. Dwight W. Mr. Brad B. Mr. Will A. Mr. Dewey D. Mr. Gerald W. Gerald. Jacob Mark Lorenzo. Mr. L. Mr. L. Probably have to go to room 9 at some point. So, what's going on here? Locked? Oh, we're good. We're good.
Oh, that is decent. Oh, whoa. No kidding with the mist. I can barely see my feet. That's incredible. I was not expecting that.
Fantastic art design there. I know it's not super detailed or anything, but I mean, it's supposed to be misty. And just those, like, wicked, twisted trees in the back, it looks great. can't go any farther, not even if I wanted to. Alright, whatever. We didn't really bring our splashy boots, did we? I wanna play in the puddles. Alright, let's get out of here. I thought his head was on backwards for a second. Character model glitch! Alright, nobody freak out. I'm not going in the ladies' room. It's not Silent Hill right now. Get tasered. Take me some salad. Come on, man. Want my make-your-own crepe station? More people. I better dive in and eat. I'm starving. Well, food! Food! Ah, whatever. Maybe we got a counter here or something? Talk to some people? What up, madame? No? Okay, cool. Sir, may I steal your food? No, nobody wants to talk to me, eh? These are all new people. Sir, could I see the back of your head? I just want to see if you have a barcode. It's the only way that I'll feel safe, knowing that you do not have a tattoo on the back of your head. I wonder if this guy will talk. What's up, dog? Come on. Oh, fuck. You're sitting way back. Wait, is he using chopsticks? Oh, I don't know. You don't get to see it for long enough. Heart is where the food is. Oh, this game. I agree with you 100%. I'm sitting here with a bag of barbecue chips, a bag of jalapeno chips, and a bag of trail mix. There's nothing, eh? Well, what the fuck? Can't talk to anybody. I can't get any food. That was a waste of time. Try this food one more time here. Nothing, eh? Can't just turn around in this one. Oh my god. Wow. Well, I feel like an idiot. Hey guys. Huh? Nice music change. Do we know him, Brad? Sure do not. I don't think so, Gerald. I think introductions are in order.
Indeed, my good sir.
My name is Gerald, and this is Brad, my sidekick.
Cool.
Hey. Ha! Huh. Please forgive us for our nonsense, Mr. Jacob Reeves. Nice to meet you, Gerald. Brad? When did you arrive? Today? Sorry, this must be a poor first impression, but I'm not quite sure. I kind of woke up in this place. I haven't the faintest idea how I ended up in here. I'm sorry to hear that, Jacob. it's not so bad if you compare it to the place I got here from. Hmm? It's nothing. I must look like a mess. Sorry, guys. Don't worry, Jacob. We all have our demons. Besides, this place is great. What it comes to resting. I think this place is great when it comes to resting is what it should be, but what do I know? I hope so. I really want to get my issues sorted out. Don't worry. Have you met our shrink yet? Clifford? Yeah. He seems like a very nice guy. Indeed. And if there is a fix for you, he finds it. Yeah, he's a genius. Be sure to listen to what he says. We are in good hands. We really are. Just try to relax and rest. I sure will. Thanks, guys. No worries, Jacob. We are all friends here. I could use that now. Okay, I should eat while my porridge is still warm. I don't know about y'all, but that does not look like porridge to me. Just saying. Also, you're cutting it and putting it up into your mouth. Pills. Okay.
Just don't give a shit. Take your pills and stuff them.
I can't believe it took me so long to find that plate that was just sitting there. My God. Morning. Here's your pill, Mr. L. Morning, Gerald. Morning, Brad. Morning, Jacob. We have not met before. No, we have not. My name is Jenny. I'm from the medical staff. How are you? Hey, Jenny. I'm better already. I'm glad to hear that. Here's your medicine. Cool. I like some medicine. Mr. Russell asked me to give you this medicine. It should help you to relax. Oh, all right. Thank you. It was nice meeting you, Jacob. See you later. I like how every dude, even in the middle of a sane asylum, is wearing like a blazer. Good morning, Lorenzo. Here's your medicine. That should be all. Catch you gentlemen later. Thanks, lady. Preempted it. Bye, Jenny! Ninja'd that dialogue. Now hypnotherapy time? Thank you. Oh, you're gonna blank me out to my therapy time.
Hey, man, cafeteria's closed. Rude you! Hey, man, get out of here!
No, I'm not going there!
Fucking face first into a buffet pail. This guy's like me, he eats like a champion. Everybody's all like, oh, I'm full. Plus, look how little there was on that plate, and it has changed none at all. It's the never-ending plate of porridge. I can't believe it took me that long to find that plate sitting on the table. Wow. Looked right over that. And now people want to talk. Hey, Mark. Jacob. You had breakfast? I did. You must have met some people. Yeah, I talked to Gerald and Brad and also Jenny. Gerald and Brad. Now there's a weird duo. In a good way. They're nice folks. And everybody likes Jenny, of course. Of course, everybody likes Jenny. Yeah. Say, it's supposed to be morning. Why is it still so dark in here? It's almost always dark in this place. See, we are located pretty high, and the place is covered with mist. That mist filters most of the sunlight, so we have to keep the lights on all day. And as if it would not be enough, the weather has been pretty awful. It is overcast and raining all the time. We have lots of power outages. I explain why they don't have a TV. Basically useless. You must have noticed all the flickering lights. Well, there you go. Ah, well, it makes a lot more sense now. Okay, I better get going now. Bye, Mark. Catch you later, Jacob. It's raining. I don't think anybody's just gonna be. You know what? To prevent myself from having to come back down here. I figured nobody would be sitting outside in the rain, but you never know. We're a bunch of nutcases. We got some music going now. Get some understanding up in this bitch. Got some empathy right here. Ah. Oh. It just gets so powerful. Oh, there we go. So the clock kind of does work. It just, you know, you have to pass a certain stage. Breakfast till noon, eh? Decent. As I get closer and closer, it just builds. Oh, you know what? Oh, shite. That is not what I wanted. Hello, tall man. My name is Jacob. Okay, I'd better get going now. Alright.
The Necroma paper. Every week is a new...
I don't know. Tried to go somewhere with it, but... Hey, Jacob, a penny for your thoughts. Hey, Gerald. Why are you reading a newspaper made of human skin? I've been thinking about things I have been through lately. There are some things that just make absolutely no sense. I'm sure you'll figure them out. Thanks, Gerald. I really hope so. Alright, catch you later. Jenny! Jenny! Hi, Jenny. Good day to you, Jacob. How are you? Whoops, sorry. Pretty good, thanks. Would you tell me about this place, Jenny? Sure. As you probably have noticed, we are located pretty high up. There's lots of mist outside, and it drains the light, so it's usually pretty dim here. Yeah, Mark explained this to me. Oh, that's nice of him. We opened our doors around a year ago. This place used to be an old mining house a long time ago. So once they ceased their operations, the local bureaucracy stated this place as a listed building. We were looking for a place to set up our treatment, and the rest is history. Now the building is used again, and in exchange, we take good care of it. Great. Well, I mean, good care of it is, I guess, one way to look at it. With a quick look around, it seems like a really nice place. Thank you, Jacob. Talk to you later. Jenny! Even runs. Yeah. Alright. Hey, Brad. How's it going? Hi, Jacob. I'm alright. Trying to relax and get my things straight. Word. Aren't all of us. And yourself? Settled in yet? I'm well. All the people seem nice, and this place has certain vibe to it. For the first time in a long while, I feel a bit better. Great to hear that, Jacob. Alright, talk to you later, Brad. Catch you later. Alrighty, man. Mr. Ludovig? Can't interrupt this guy.
He's too cool for fans.
I want to paint my feelings about the guy who is too cool for fans.
God damn it, allow me to paint my feelings. Jenny, they're repressing me. It's hindering my recovery, Jenner.
Yeah, I don't want to have to go through all that talking again, so... Blam. Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
It's literally just becoming noon. At all times in this room. I would have been cool with that music still echoing through this hallway. I also could have seen how some people would have gotten annoyed or bored with it. Hey, Dak, hypnotize me. All pronto-like and stuff. I was going to try to look through the window, but again, I don't think I see him in there, so I'm thinking this is probably going to be locked. They won't let me paint my feelings. I've talked to everybody in that room. Let's go pay Mr. L another visit, shall we? Oh, man. It's locked, right? What was that? Oh, the shadows followed me. The evil followed me out of my brain. Huh? I think it came from room 8. Oh, I was right. Open the door! Open the door! Kick it in, bro. Come on. Somebody's in trouble. Do not delay a reaction. It's gone. No, 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 please. What's wrong? It's gone! Gone! Okay, calm down. What's gone? Mrs. Chanel. Huh? You lost your wife? Worse! Mrs. Chanel is Lorenzo's bunny! We must find it immediately. And she's gone! She is there, all alone! We must find the bunny! Calm down. Where was it, Lorenzo? Yes. Lorenzo can't go looking for her. You have to help poor Lorenzo. Well, I'll keep my eyes peeled. Thank you. Lorenzo will wait in case Mrs. Chanel will return home. You do that. I'll get going. Take care. Aw. But the bunny. Alright, that's it. I'm kicking in doors until I find this bunny. Nobody robs Lorenzo of his bunny. Bunny! Okay. Who's got Mr. Lorenzo's bunny? Swear to God, I will find the kidnapper! Wait. No, I will find the bunny napper. Did you steal the bunny? Don't lie to me or I'll rip your room apart. It's locked. Swear to God, man. Hey, Mark.
Hi, Jacob.
May I ask how you wound up in here? You may. But I won't tell. Fair enough. So, do you like it here?
I do.
It's quiet in here. Peaceful. I feel I can hear my own thoughts every now and then. I'm glad to hear it works for you. Fingers crossed it will work for me, too. Don't worry, Jacob. It will. Thanks, Mark. Alright. This guy's being alright. I'll believe that you don't have the bunny. For now.
He was a man on a mission to save Lorenzo's bunny. This summer, watch the harrowing action as Jacob Reeves commits his life to saving Mrs. Chanel.
All right, Doc. Bunny? No, Bunny. Maybe I should follow the doctor. Doctor, if you stole Bunny... I'll be mad. Oh, I should have kept with him, shouldn't I? I wonder. Yeah, I probably should have stayed with that doctor. Alright. I'm here. Hey, man. What are you doing here? Oh, great. Another nutcase. Huh? It's me. Don't you recognize me? Sir, I have never seen you before. But I helped you in that motel to find the picture of your family. Oh, the guy with the safe, the 696 guy. Please go away. Wow. He straight up kicked me out. Bunny? Anyone in here seen a bunny? Yeah, it's probably happening now. Even talk to me now. They never let me paint my feelings. I feel repressed in this place. Go MS paint my feelings later. Gotta go back and check that hallway, huh? Maybe you did it. Did you steal Mrs. Chanel? Huh? Oh, wow. It took me 2 hours to find that bunny gone? Oh, and talk to this douche. Bunny! Give back Bunny. Come, now. I won't hurt you. Come on, Bunny. Can't believe I'm going to say this. Here, Mrs. Chanel. Ugh, it's no use. Huh? Ah, sorry. Don't worry about it. Is that a bunny under the table? It is. A mean one. She won't come out. Isn't that Lorenzo's bunny? Yeah. Sorry. Do I know you? My name is Jacob. What's yours? I'm afraid I can't reveal my real name, but you may call me Artist. Okay, artist. Is that your bunny?
No.
I'm merely borrowing her. See, my latest masterpiece has a bunny on it, and I needed a reference. But that stupid bunny won't stay put. And can you believe me? She bit me and jumped under the table. I can't reach her, and there is no way I will move my incomplete painting out of the way. Shoot, I shouldn't hit that. Can't you just paint her while she is under the table? Ha! And how about the light? I need to capture the very soul of it. I can't do it when she is hiding in the shadows. Okay, sorry, God. Did you know Lorenzo is truly devastated because the bunny is missing? He is? Well, I don't want that. Well then, we need to get this bunny back to him, and soon as possible. As soon as possible. And that means after I have captured her essence. So we need to lure her out. Okay, I'll just talk to Lorenzo. I'm sure he can get the bunny from under the table. No, you can't do that. He would never let me paint her. We need to be very subtle. I'm almost finished with the painting, and I don't need much time to complete it. Alright, so we will lure her out. You paint her quickly, and I'll get the bunny back to Lorenzo. Yes. Now we only need to figure out how. Yep. Well, I'm off. I'll come back once I think of something. Canteen, grab some food. Maybe there's some lettuce or something. Coax the bunny out. We must save Lorenzo's bunny! It definitely took me an hour to talk to that guy, apparently. Once. People only talk to you once a day. That's. People are a once a day occurrence. And then that's enough. When you are hiding, I lose my mind. Kill me, camper, one more time. Oh! Did you guys see that? I had his head twisted backwards. Oh! Oh, man. I wanted to try to get a picture of that. Oh, that's so bad. I'm so sure he breaks his own neck. Oh, God. Oh, I thought I had saw his head on backwards before, but then, oh, it happened right there, and oh, that was bad. Oh, my God. Character model issues. That was great. That made me happy I did this video today. Salad. Nailed it! Did I not fucking call that? Tomatoes, carrots.
Brilliant.
Hello, maid lady. Do you need some help cleaning up? I'm not an asshole. You seem pretty happy. I guess we're not dirty people, eh? Plus, you don't have to fix that. Apparently the help's not allowed to talk to the patients. Alright, is that carrot? Yeah, let's get this carrot. Save Lorenzo's bunny! Crazy bunny nappers. So my head being able to switch 180 degrees like that just further supports my theory that of Satan Daddy. I'm the omen child grown up. I still find that hilarious that his body can turn like completely independent of his head all the way around too. Oh, I can't believe that. I wish I had left that and taken a screenshot of it instead of continuing to walk, and it would have stayed like that. Oh, it's so bad. Oh, that's so good. I'm assuming that only happens because the head needs to move independent of the rest of the body. Or else you wouldn't have that issue, right? But that was just fantastic. I couldn't believe that. That gave me such a giggle. I tahid and I tahad. What the shit? I want to play ball. Oh, wow. Oh, he'll actually play with you, too. That's epic. You better freaking believe. Oh, you can... Oh, that's rough. Oh, okay. I thought I kicked it. He kicked it. That's funny.
Didn't your mother ever tell you not to play ball in the house? God.
Oh, I glitched it. Yeah! Look at that, I glitched it. I fucking glitched it. That's hilarious.
Nice miss. Ha ha.
Is it just me or does his one arm never move? He's just only ever swinging the one arm. Did you break one, Chief? Or wouldn't surprise me after all the shit we've been through. Who wants a nice juicy carrot? Let's capture some bunny essence. Hey, look what I found. Nice thinking. That should do the trick. Okay, let's lure her out.
Get ready.
Come on, bunny. This is such epic music. This is such good, like, epic fucking music for bunny luring.
Gotta lure the bunny. Gotta lure the bunny. Gotta lure the bunny. Bunny. Gotta lure the bunny. Finish.
Come here, bunny. Come here, bunny. Oh! Showed you, bunny. Mrs. Chanel, come over here. Come on, Bunny. Here, Bunny.
Here, Bunny, Bunny.
Gotta capture the bunny. Gotta capture the bunny. Looks like I'm about to jam this carrot in that guy's pooper.
Hey, bunny, bunny, bunny.
This is Chanel, come over here.
Here, bunny, 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 bunny. Here, bunny, 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 bunny. Here, bunny.
Free carrot. Come on. You know you want it, bunny.
You know you want it. Come get the carrot, bunny. Come on.
This is like the oddest mini game to be doing. In this whole game has just been so dark and twisted, and then capture the bunny. This is by far the oddest part of this game I've ever played. Yeah, that's right, you climb right into my pocket.
Aww. Look at that bunny.
Look at the bunny. Look at the bunny. Look at the bunny, bunny, bunny. Look at the bunny, 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 bunny.
Okay, I'm done. We did it. Fat Rabbit's dynamite. Indeed. Now hand her over, and I'll finish with my art.
I don't want him to kill the bunny.
What do you mean, no? We had agreement. You can't. You worthless fool. You and Lorenzo, you deserve each other. Farewell, fool. You have no idea what you have just done.
I saved a bunny, bro. I don't trust you, man.
You give me some creeps, and I don't want you around a bunny, okay? I'm the bunny savior. I'm the bunny champion. I'm the banampion. That's right, I'm a banampion, and you can deal with it. Wear my long ears and puffball tail with pride, bitch.
If you want to see a hardcore bunny, look up Bunnicula. Bunnicula is insane. I can't believe it was a kid's cartoon. And apparently storybook. Darcy told me that her grandma, I think, used to read her little Bunnicula storybooks.
Here you go, Lorenzo. Hey, Lorenzo, look who I have here. Mrs. Chanel! You're back. Thank you, Mr. Jacob. Lorenzo is forever in your debt. Don't worry about it, Lorenzo. Okay, I'll get going. Bye. Bye, Mrs. Chanel. Aww. I saved you from that bad, bad man. Social services, we're here to check on the bunny. Oh God, what did you do to the bunny?
What did you do to the bunny? Oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God.
Oh. All right, boys and girls. As we can see here, the doctor is back and he's ready for... Oh no, he's seeing somebody else right now. So I won't be able to do my hypnotherapy yet. He is meeting a patient. I almost made that mistake. Okay, I'm gonna go back. Now that the bunny is safe, I can sleep easy for one more day. Another bunny life was saved. He will never have to worry about that bad man hurting him again. It sickens me to think of the creeps that live in this town. When a bunny can't walk the streets and feel safe, no one is free. Huh. 7 o'clock, getting kind of late, eh? So yeah, probably the next thing we'll have to do is go back to my room, go to bed for the night. And then tomorrow will probably be that first round of hypnotherapy they were talking about. But, unfortunately, this video has already run way too long. I know there's some I can cut out. But, we're definitely going to end it here for now. Bunny is home safe with her. Owner, and we can feel good about ourselves. Alrighty, so I'm Bruce Dauthi Taylor, and as always, thank you so much for joining us here on Silence of the Sleep, a game by Jesse McConan.